Perfect.
Hello everyone, Lycanroc Hedgehog here, and today we're going to review Pac-Man World for the PlayStation. And also for the... I will talk about there being a Game Boy Advance version of this game. Though we're not going to really go into that one. But anyways, let's talk about Pac-Man World. I remember taking a look at Pac-Man World back during my freshman year of high school. It was on PSN, so I had to get it because I wasn't like, wait, when did the first Pac-Man World come out? Because the first Pac-Man game I've ever played was Pac-Man World 2. But anyways, what's the gameplay like for Pac-Man World? Well, the gameplay is basically a 3D game, but sometimes, or should I say most of the times, it's a 3D linear game. There are other things to do within a level of Pac-Man World, but I really won't go into that. So yeah, basically, a Pac-Man is just your average 3D linear game, as far as I can say. There are some things about this game that do have 3D in it, but not that much. It's linear. Like a 3D side-scroller, to say. So what's the plot about? Well, it's Pac-Man's 20th birthday. And all of his friends get kidnapped by a metal version of him named Talkman, not T-A-L-K, like as in talk, like T-A, it's T-O-C, yeah, Talkman. So, basically it's sort of like the Pac-Man of Sonic CD, basically. I know for those of you who hate Sonic CD, you don't want me comparing. You don't want me comparing this to Sonic CD. But for those of you who like Sonic CD, then it's fine. I'll still say that it's comparable. Because there's a robot version of Pac-Man, and that robot version of Pac-Man takes its strengths. Even though in Sonic CD, Metal Sonic just takes the aim. But anyways, enough of that set. The story's actually kind of funny. It's not great, but it's nice and kind of funny. Not in a bad way. Like isn't a good funny way. But anyways, the gameplay is actually pretty good too. For a 3D side scroller some of the time, and having other things in it, it still plays pretty nice. I know people complain about this game sometimes, but it's really not all that bad. So, what's the bosses like in Pac-Man World? Well, sometimes it can be rather frustrating. This game is somewhat difficult. As you struggle through each part of the island to rescue all your friends from Talkman, who, in spoiler terms, is actually Orson. Yeah, I said spoiler terms, meaning that you should have skipped to here. But anyways, what's the graphics like in Pac-Man World? The graphics are pretty nice for the time when it came out on the PlayStation. So, well, I don't really have anything bad to say about the graphics. What's the music like in Pac-Man World? The music is... I would say it's forgettable, because Pac-Man World 2's music is a lot memorable than this. Do I have any gripes with Pac-Man World? No, not that I'm aware of. I mean, this game does kind of have a weird difficulty. I'm gonna say weird. But nonetheless, it's not like a frustrating difficulty. Again, it's just a weird one. So, let's go over what we've talked about so far for Pac-Man World. The story's funny and nice. The gameplay is actually pretty good. The music can be forgettable, yeah. There's nothing that gripey about this game. Why did I use that like a weird thing to say? Anyways, again, the difficulty is weird, but nothing to really complain about. So, I would give Pac-Man World a simple 7.1 out of 10. If you have a PlayStation or if you just want to get this game off of PSN, then I really recommend it because you'd have a fun time with Pac-Man World. But if not, then I suggest Pac-Man World 2. Anyways, that's all said and done. I'm Lucky Mark Hedgehog. I'll see you all next time. I hope you all like and subscribe.